welcome to another RSR. Tonight I'm reviewing CF Pachuca 1, New York Red Bulls 1, 5-4 on penalties in the League's Cup 2024 group stage. Red Bulls are eliminated. Pachuca advances. Toronto advances. No worries on Sunday. All they have to worry about is they could put out TFC 2 if they want. Hell, they could go for the win if they want. It doesn't matter. They're through. Thank you, Pachuca. Gracias, Los Tuzos. Red Bulls. Dominate the first 50 minutes. Lose the game anyway. That's so Metro. Even against a Pachuca that looks shaky and trash. And frankly, probably didn't deserve to win this match. That's so Metro. CF Pachuca. 1. New York Red Bulls. 1. 5-4 en penales. En la League Cup fase de grupos. Pachuca avanzar. Red Bulls eliminado. Toronto avanzar. What a game. I don't know if I would say what a game, but it was good enough for me. Good enough for me. Good for you and good for me. Good for you. Good for me. I can't do the Gunny Ermy voice. With that being said, halftime was 0-0. Cero a cero, middle tiempo. I think both sides had a moment in this game. The first 50 minutes were Red Bulls. Red Bulls should have blown this game out of the water in the first 50 minutes. They should have won this in the first 50 minutes. This should have never went to penalties. The chances that team had, this game should have been over by the 50th minute. Really should have. But they don't score until the 47th minute. Pachuca wakes up, game changes. But that first half was Red Bulls. It really was. The chances Red Bulls had, the front foot that they were on, they played it like a final. Sandro Schwartz basically said, we got to play this game like a final. He did. They did play it like a final. They put everybody on. They started their best team that they could have, except Tolkien, of course, was out. Forsberg was out due to injury and Tolkien being at the Olympics. But most of their best team was on the pitch. Pachuca is still figuring things out. They've only scored 3 goals all season since July. Since they've restarted play in the Apertura, they've only scored 3 goals. 3 goals. 2 losses, 2 draws, 1 win. Technically 1.5 wins if you want to count the penalty shootout win. They've only scored 3 goals. 3. And 2 of those came in the same game. So they've only scored in 2 games of the 5 that they've played. And they could have lost this one too. And frankly, they probably should have lost this one. Pachuca are shaky. They are shaky as all hell right now. And honestly, that last 30 minutes until after they got scored on was honestly the Pachuca that I'm more used to seeing. And even then, it still wasn't that good. They weren't world beaters. They got what they needed, but they still weren't world beaters. Goals are scored as follows in the second half. The 47th minute, Elias Manoel scores a horrible giveaway by Pachuca. Goes to Lewis Morgan. Lewis Morgan plays it on to Elias Manoel. Elias Manoel takes a banger of a shot because it moved the net. Under the bar, off the underside of the bar, and in for a goal in the 47th minute. 0-1, 0-1. Great goal from Elias Manoel. That's the type of goal they need from him. If he missed that, he would really be bad. Luckily for Red Bulls, he scored it. He put it away. Good, good play. Then, in the 57th minute, Owen dispossesses Kyle Duncan. Plays it on. Crosses it into the box. To Solomon Rondon. Solomon Rondon takes an amazing shot into the near post. Slides it in, scores the goal that Pachuca needs to tie the game up at the very least. 1-1, 1-1, Solomon Rondon saves Pachuca again because that's what he does. 1-1. And from that goal that the Red Bulls scored up till the 90th minute, Pachuca did dominate the game. They deserved to get that goal, and honestly, they probably should have got a winner themselves. Solomon Rondon should have scored 2 goals in this game. Cornell made a big save late on to make sure this went to a shootout. Then, Pachuca had to make a big defensive play to make sure this went to a shootout. But in the end, full time, 1-1, 1-1 esta noche. We go to penalties. Vamos, la penales. We go to penalties. Penalty takers, Noah Eel scores his to make it 0-1. Solomon Rondon has Cornell go the other way. Solomon Rondon scores. You expect him to do that. 1-1, 1-1. Sean Nialis scores his penalty, 1-2. Gustavo Cabral bangs home a penalty, 2-2, 2-2. Wickelman Carmona scored against Tirana. He scores against Pachuca, 2-3. Arturo Gonzalez scores his penalty, 3-3, 3-3. Elias Manuel bangs home his penalty, 3-4. Angel Mena, the new Pachuca player, as well as former León legend, knows how to take penalties. He slots it home, bangs it home, 4-4, 4-4. Luis Morgan puts it over the bar to put Pachuca in the catbird seat with one kick to go. Nelson de Alsa, or Luis Morgan puts it way wide. My bad. Luis Morgan puts it way wide. Nelson de Alsa puts it over the bar to make sure we go to another round of penalties. 4-4, 4-4. Dylan Nialis puts it right down the middle. It gets saved by Moreno. He goes down to his knees, makes the save. It's still 4-4, 4-4. And Sergio De Los Rios, he scores his penalty, and he wins it for Pachuca. 5-4, 5-4. Amazing, amazing, amazing penalty by De Los Rios. Comes up as a Cantera kid, smashes it home, wins the game, lets Pachuca advance in the Leagues Cup, and helps Toronto advance as well. And we will see how that game goes on Sunday. After penalties, it was 1-1. 1-1 esta noche. 5-4 on penalties. 5-4 en penales. Pachuca wins. Pachuca ganar y avanzar. Full-time stats are as follows. 7 shots to 17. 2 shots on goal to 5. 65% possession to 35% possession. 611 passes to 330. 82% pass accuracy to 70%. 8 fouls to 9. 2 offside to 0. 2 yellow cards to 4. 0 red cards to 0. 3 corners to 2. Listen, you can't let Pachuca stay alive. That's the one big thing here. Red Bulls let them stay alive when they could have just put them away. They lose the game. They get eliminated for their troubles. But Pachuca are still shaky. They are still shaky. Toronto probably won't play as well as Red Bulls did to play Pachuca. But they are playing at their own stadium. That does help. And Pachuca's still shaky. And Toronto, maybe they got belief. Maybe they have belief when they watch this game and say, hey, we go out with a blaze of glory. If we don't win, so be it. We're through. If we win, we get first place. Probably have to play Miami, but we'd have to play Tigres anyway if we finish second. We have to play somebody hard anyway in the next round. We're through. We have to play somebody hard for us. Let's see if we could keep it close against them as well. We got to go out with a blaze of glory. And I think they will, to a certain extent. I think they will go for it, and they can get it. I'm not saying they will. I'm not saying I think they will get it, but they can get it. Pachuca are shaky at best. And yes, Pachuca woke up in the last 30 minutes. I don't think you can score a goal on them and just let that stand and hope for the best. I think you have to score a couple. But we will find out how this goes. But Pachuca deservedly, I think, well, I'd say they were better at the shootout. Regular time, I think they deserve to lose. I think Red Bulls absolutely fumbled the bag. I think Red Bulls fumbled the bag. They should have won this game. They should be alive or even advanced onto the next round tonight. But they did not. And now they're eliminated because they fumbled the bag multiple times throughout both these games. And Toronto advances in their stead while Pachuca advances as well because of how this tournament works. Toronto, I think, deservedly advances because they played well enough to advance. I think deservedly they did advance, but in the end, they definitely could have put more into this game as a, hey, or more into the last game as a, hey, we gotta go. But with that being said, Toronto, happy to see them advance. I'm over the moon. Thank you. Gracias, Los Tuzos. See you on Sunday. And congratulations on advancing as well. Felicidades, Pachuca. Congratulations, Toronto. Commiserations, Red Bulls. We're moving on, baby. No worries on Sunday. Just can we go out in a blaze of glory and give us some hope onto their next matches or even win? But the result doesn't matter. It's the performance that matters at this point on Sunday for Toronto. How good was the performance is what matters. And I'd rather it be like that, especially against the CONCACAF champions. Can they make a statement? We'll find out. But Pachuca got the shootout win. Red Bulls eliminated. You shouldn't have fumbled the bag. Toronto, you're on too because they fumbled the bag. So let's get it. Let's go. With that being said, if you like this video, like it, share, subscribe. You know what it is. Tell your friends. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Hit that bell notification on subscribe. Send some chats on the live streams. Comment on this video. Put us in play. Share with friends and family. All that great stuff. I will see you tomorrow for a live watch along of both Chelsea versus Club America and Tigres versus Puebla. And we will review Tigres versus Puebla once that's over. And I'll see you on Thursday for some Central American Cup action. Friday, I'll see you for USA versus Morocco in the Olympics. So that'll be a good one as well. And we'll have one review each day, two lives. Well, on Thursday, it'll be just one live, but at least one live, one review. But for the next 2 days, two lives, two reviews. Two lives, one review. One live, one review on Thursday. Or Friday. Friday. But there you go. Let's go. Vamos. Gracias, Los Tuzos. Vamos, Toronto. I'll see you later. I'm Ron and I'm out. Peace.